A family's fight for justice is getting support at the government level. Rachael Wersbicki was murdered in November of 2018. The man accused of killing her was temporarily released on bail, prompting public outcry. Tonight, Nikki Dementri spoke with Wersbicki's parents in West Seneca, where town leaders are trying to send a message to Albany.
Tears were shed and cheers took over the West Seneca Town Board meeting Monday night after lawmakers made it clear they want the justice system changed. An army of Rachael's warriors filled the room, all in memory of Rachael Wersbicki. The 22-year-old was allegedly murdered by her ex-boyfriend Shane Casado in November 2018. It was shortly after Casado was briefly released on bail last year. Assemblyman Pat Burke sponsored the Justice for Rachael Act. It would let judges hold dangerousness hearings in hopes of preventing this from happening again. On Monday night, West Seneca lawmakers unanimously supported the act. They also affirmed Senator Pat Gallivan's supporting bill. When the vote came down, Rachael's family and friends clutched their necklaces. Rachael was with them in that room. Each necklace contained her ashes.
For me, I would think that Rachael's biggest joy would be knowing that something that happened to her and happened to us won't happen to other people. It's a tragedy, and then having people like that walk around after the fact is just adding insult to injury. And we're not the only family that was affected by this, but hopefully we might be the last family that's affected like this.
Assemblyman Pat Burke says in a statement, "Our hard work is paying off and we are building critical momentum. I will continue fighting to get this legislation passed." Casado's jury trial is slated for the end of this month. In the newsroom, Nikki Dementri, 7 Eyewitness News.